In this episode, the body is invaded by influenza. Influenza is a virus, a group of pathogens which are incapable of replicating on its own. Instead, they enter the host cells, hijack the replication machinery and resources for replication, and subsequently exit the cell, possibly killing it. This lines up very well with the portrayal of virally infected cells as zombies, as they are now under the mercy of their viral overlords. Influenza is a negative strand, single-stranded RNA virus, and has 6 to 8 RNA segments. Projecting out of the virus capsules are the major glycoproteins, hemagglutinin, which facilitates the attachment and entry of the virus to the host cell, and uraminidase, which facilitates the release of newly produced viruses. These two structures are used as a nomenclature for naming influenza strains. Your immune system is once again needed to control this threat. This time, we are introduced to another cell from the innate immune system, the macrophage. Unlike neutrophils, macrophages are professional antigen-presenting cells, APCs for short, where they can pick up extracellular antigens and present them on major histocompatibility complex class 2 molecules. All cells too have the ability to present antigens, but only intracellular antigens, which are presented on MHC1 molecules. These antigens are inspected by T cells, which are part of your adaptive immune system. The adaptive immune system consists of B cells and T cells and are collectively known as lymphocytes. Unlike the innate immune cells, which recognize general antigens commonly found in pathogens, lymphocytes have receptors which recognize a small fragment of antigens known as epitopes. In a healthy body, all antigens presented belong to the self and will not be recognized by the lymphocytes, as those that react with self-antigens have been removed by negative selection. You will learn about negative selection in episode 9. During an infection, foreign antigens will be present in the body and will be recognized by lymphocytes. T cells recognize fragments of antigens which have been processed by cells and are divided into killer T cells and helper T cells. Killer T cells express CD8 receptors and recognize antigens presented on MHC1 molecules. They are known to be cytotoxic and kill infected cells. Helper T cells express CD4 receptors and recognize antigens presented on MHC2 molecules and influence the activation of other immune cells, including B cells. B cells recognize the surface of antigens and target pathogens possessing these epitopes, preventing their entry in a process known as neutralization. The B cell shown in cell set work is not a B cell, but rather a plasma cell, a type of B cell that secretes antibodies. The adaptive immune system, as its name suggests, adapts to infections and has a reduced response time on exposure to a pathogen which was previously encountered. But to reach such a level of efficiency requires lots of training. We start with naive cells which have never encountered a pathogen before, with receptors created at random. A large number of naive cells allows the body to respond to a wide range of novel pathogens. However, which receptors correspond to the most common epitopes? Which receptors correspond to epitopes which are virtually non-existent? This will be determined during infections, where APCs, macrophages, and dendritic cells pick up antigens and move to the lymph node, and screen naive cells for a matching receptor. In the event of a match, the naive cells are activated by embarrassing photos of their seniors, cytokines secreted by dendritic cells, becoming effector cells, and replicates, dramatically increasing your body's ability to handle an infection. After the battle, most of the short-lived effector cells will die, but there are some naive cells which have differentiated into memory cells and live longer, ready to fight the pathogens if they are encountered again. All your body's encounter with antigens would culminate into a pool of circulating lymphocytes which recognize epitopes which your body is most frequently exposed to. This is a property of the adaptive immune system, immunologic memory. Repeated encounter of the same pathogen increases the number of lymphocytes with the matching receptors, increasing the likelihood of finding a match should the pathogen be encountered again. This reduces response time and prevents the body from succumbing to the symptoms of the pathogen. The immune system eventually succeeds in wiping out the influenza-infected cells, until it encounters a new influenza virus which neither the effector T cell nor B cell could fight. This is due to a new virus possessing an antigen structure which does not contain the epitope recognized by both cells. New strains can also arise from mutation, which changes the genetic structure and in turn the peptide structure lacking the recognized epitope. There will be a need to find another matching naive cell. Pathogens which constantly mutate and evolve to evade immune detection, and the immune system will once again need to catch up, creating a constant arms race between pathogens and the immune system.